Hi everyone, welcome into this week's My Weekly CBS Fix. Once again, this week's fix is dedicated as a refuah shlema for Yisrael Amichai, Ben Sarah Amichai, we love you, get better soon. In this week's Parshas Yisrael, we have the Ten Commandments. I'd like to talk to you about the last of them, which is not to covet. It is forbidden for a Jewish person to covet or desire something that does not belong to us, belongs to somebody else, and the question is, why not? What is wrong with wanting something that somebody else owns and I want it? Now, strictly speaking, there's nothing wrong with wanting what they have. You want what they have, you can go get it yourself. There's nothing wrong. If somebody has a good wife, go get a good wife. Somebody has a nicer car, you can get a nicer car. Somebody has a nicer house or a nice house or a house to begin with, go get one. There's the ways and means about doing it. You can certainly go get one. To covet, though, is something else. To covet means that you're angry or you're so full of desire that you don't have it, that you want it, and they shouldn't have it. And you really are trying to scheme your way of either you yourself getting it or trying to set the record straight. And the reason why it's forbidden is because the first commandment is, I am Hashem, your God, that took you out of the land of Egypt from the house of slavery. And there's no commandment over there. Maimonides explains that while it is not a commandment in itself, what Hashem is telling us is that every person has to always have that mitzvah, that commandment, in the forefront of his mind, that there is a God. Why? Because without belief in God, none of the other commandments of the Torah would make any sense or really have any validity. There's really no reason why I shouldn't steal, and there's really no reason why I shouldn't murder. At the end of the day, why not? Why can't I do it? So I'm going to kill people, so what? So I take people's money, so what? So I'm going to, why do I have to honor my, why do I have to keep Shabbos? What if, should I honor my father or mother? Why do I have to do anything? If there's no God, then really, at the end of the day, there's no reason why you can't do anything. And the 10th commandment says, thou shalt not covet, which means Hashem knows what he's doing. If you were supposed to get a certain house, you would get it. If you were supposed to get a certain woman as your wife or a man as a husband, you would get that person. If you were supposed to have a certain job, Hashem would give you. If you were supposed to have a certain amount of money, Hashem would give it to you. When it says not to covet, covet is feelings of anger and nervousness, and I'm not in control. You're basically saying, Hashem messed up. Hashem doesn't mess up. Everything is perfectly calculated, each according to a person's deeds. And if you want something, then find a merit to go get it. But for you to covet and think that something is uncontrolled over here, that you're supposed to have it, or that he's not supposed to have it, or that she's not supposed to have it, then that's just flat out wrong. It's in a certain sense, it's idol worship. Because who do you end up serving when you think like that? Serve yourself. Me. It's all about me, and I'm supposed to have, and they're not supposed to have. But when we live with Hashem, there's a sense of calm in your life. I'm not supposed to have it. It's not for me. If Hashem wants to give it to me, I'll get it. And not only that, you should think the contrary. Let them have it. They should have blessing in that home. They should have blessing with that car. They should have blessing with everything that they do have. And be happy for them. Because if they have it, they merited it somehow. And if they merited it somehow, it's probably through good deeds. And you should be happy then for that person that they have it. And it just allows for unity to come. Instead, it breaks down your entire moral fabric, and you become unsprung, and you don't know what to do with yourself, and you're living a life of, you don't know, you're not in control. Don't worry, Hashem is in control. He's got your back. Trust him. That's the 10th commandment. A little brief explanation. Thank you for listening. Have a wonderful Shabbos.